Counter-Current Radicals. Enter by the narrow gate, for wide is the gate and broad is the way that leads to destruction. And there are many who go in by it. Matthew 7:13. To follow Jesus requires a narrow path. Actually, it appears that following the crowd is so much more fun and easy to do. However, the crowd wide gate leads to destruction. Becoming friends with the world equals breaking up with God. The line has been drawn, and it's very clear. We have a choice. We either walk with God with determination and obedience, or enjoy the empty promises offered by the world. We are in a particular season that requires for us to be radical with Jesus. We have pressing issues to decide to support or be against, because these have no middle ground. For example, you are either an abortionist or a pro-life supporter. There is no such thing as a partial abortion. When it comes to racism, you can either love and respect every race, or you can choose only to prefer your own and possibly other of your likeness. You can also choose to accept immigrants in your country who are looking for a better future for their families, or you can reject them because they don't seem to be of any value to your standards. You can continue to watch and even support sex trafficking in your city, or you can be radical and do something about it. You can either define marriage as a covenant between a man and a woman, or you can support other types of arrangements. You can do something about poverty in your city, or you can indulge in compulsive consumption. As you can tell, the above issues are just the top of the iceberg in debating between what is right or wrong. Noah was a radical. While living surrounded by a wicked generation, he accepted the call from God to build an ark in order to save his family and himself. At a time when it wasn't cool to be righteous for God, when the destruction came, many regretted mocking Noah. Abraham broke away from his father's idol making and worshiping. He listened and obeyed God to go to a place which he had no knowledge of, and his future descendants will receive an inheritance. Lot was singled out by the angels to leave Sodom and Gomorrah before these were destroyed for his wickedness. Moses did not want to be called the son of Pharaoh's daughter. He chose affliction instead of the commodities available to him. David preferred to flee from Saul, his father-in-law, rather than to take the kingdom by force. The Bible is packed with radical figures who left all types of comfort in order to serve and obey God. In our days, we still have to respond to the question posed by Joshua when he was conquering territory. And if it seems evil to you to serve the Lord, choose yourself this day whom you will serve, whether the gods which your fathers served were on the other side of the river, or the gods of the Amorites, in whose land you dwell. But as for me and my house, we will serve the Lord. Joshua 24:15. God is calling you to be a radical in a generation which is filled with confusion and hopelessness. It is time for you to be counted in the army of the Lord as a true servant of a mighty God, in Jesus' name.